Hi, I'm Martha York with the Active Jackson Coalition for Move It Mondays, and I want to do a little trekking pole demonstration today. I want to share with you a couple things about trekking poles that are so great. First of all, they're very compact, so you can fit them in a suitcase. You can take them with you when you travel. I do it all the time. And I find that using trekking poles has increased my confidence when I'm out and about trying to hike. I've been able to stay a lot more physically active using trekking poles in a way that builds up my stamina as well as my balance, and has made me not have any falls since I've been using trekking poles. But there are a couple things you need to know about a trekking pole in order to know how to fit them properly as well as how to use them. So the first thing that I like to do is I like to demonstrate you want about a 90 degree angle on your elbow when it's upright. So you want to get that to the height that works for you. And that's the beauty of it. It's adjustable. The other thing is they've got straps on it for your wrists. And what you want to do is go in from the bottom and loop it around so that it's snugly hanging on your wrist, but it's there in case you were to drop it, or if you were kind of losing your grip for a second, you're not going to lose your pole. It's going to stay with you. The beauty of trekking poles is they give you a much better posture when you're walking, but they also give you the ability to navigate an uneven ground like this one. If you look, this grass is really lumpy. There's a hill behind me, but when I'm using a trekking pole, there's some things that I can do to improve my confidence when I'm navigating uneven surfaces like this. So part of what happens with a trekking pole is if you are going uphill, you want to use it like it was a handrail. You're going to put it in front of you to help give you leverage when you're going up. It's going to give you that extra strength of your upper body to help hold you upright when you're going uphill. But the same thing applies when you're going downhill. It's going to be a little bit in front of you to give you what feels like a little bit of an advantage, like a little bit of a handrail that's out in the middle of nature. So that keeps you upright and keeps you a little bit stronger and sturdier. There is a trick to walking with them as well. You want your opposite leg with the opposite trekking pole to go together. You don't want to do right and right, left and left. You want it to be more like this, where you've got one foot in front of the other, but you're alternating the poles that way. Another thing that's important to keep in mind is that when you are walking, you want it to be sort of a loose gait where it's sort of on an angle next to you and is just kind of gliding with you as you're walking. You don't have to have it something that's totally wedged in and sturdy every single step of the way, but the idea is that if you hit something uneven, you've got that extra confidence. You've got something that you can hang on to. So it is a good idea to practice walking with your trekking poles before you get out on the trails. I encourage you to do this in a parking area. In fact, come on with me and we're going to do that together with Lori and Norma.